In this video, I will show you how to take an eBird checklist and import it into the Ontario Breeding Bird Atlas.
Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to head to the Atlas website and we're going to click on Login. And here, once we've gotten to the login page, we click Sign In and we're going to add our credentials. Sign in. Okay, once we're logged in, we're going to hover over Submit and click Submit Data. And you should recognize this page. Now, instead of if we were doing a regular entering checklist ourselves, then we would zoom in and select our location, but we're going to import from eBird, so click the Import from eBird button. Your eBird login and eBird password are required, so those you need to enter. If you've entered them through your NatureCounts Atlas account in the profile, then it should be there already. If not, fill them in. You can click the Save My eBird Login in My Profile option, and that way you won't have to keep entering it each time. The last thing you need is the eBird Checklist ID, so you need to head to your eBird Checklist to get that. So I'm going to head over there. You can find the Checklist ID in the URL, the address bar. It's that number that starts with an S and ends with 7 or 8 numbers. You can also find it right in the checklist just above the date. So I'm going to highlight that. You can click Control C or you can right click and select copy. Then I'm going to head back to the Atlas and I'm going to right click and paste that into the checklist ID. And then I'm just going to click Import from eBird. It can take a couple seconds to load it up. It depends on lots of factors like how fast your internet is and how busy the network is, how many other people are doing this, and so on. Okay, once it's brought it in, you're going to be at this page. There is, in this case, a little warning up at the top saying your form contains one or more rare species or high counts. So this is just giving you a heads up that there's some stuff to pay extra close attention to at the next page. But on this page, you're just going to have your location should have been brought in. It's going to have imported the track log if you had one. It's going to import all the other stuff like the checklist type, observation type, date, time, everything like that should have been brought in. Just double check to make sure it's correct and then click continue. All right. Now on this, the next page is the fun part. This is where you edit the contents of your checklist. So it should have brought in the number of individuals and the breeding evidence code from eBird. There's some slight differences in terms of the exact breeding codes and their codes. Between eBird and the Atlas. They should be translated properly going back and forth though, but just keep an eye on that. And so normally what you do is you just scroll through this, make sure everything was brought in properly, there weren't any errors, anything missing. I'm just going to zoom through it pretty quick. I'm going to click Submit. Now it's saying the checklist contains some errors and they're shown in red. So I'm going to return to the checklist and here's the error right away. We've got a red warning on the breeding evidence code used for brown-headed cowbird. So if you click it, it'll tell you the issue. So brown-headed cowbird, NB code, which is the one I was using, see it's highlighted in yellow. This species does not build a nest, and the red means it's an invalid code. And so this is one of the checks that the Atlas does on top of stuff that eBird would do. And so these are the sorts of things you need to pay attention to when you're importing from eBird. So the species doesn't build a nest. So obviously I made a mistake. So I'm going to delete that. And that will get rid of that warning. Now I'm going to try submitting again. Okay. Now the last check is there's some species that are rare that have been reported. So there's a different icon beside each one. So blue-wing teal, that is the regionally rare symbol, the double dagger. The black-billed cuckoo has that orange rare icon. That means it's flagged by the eBird filter. Now, in the case of the black-billed cuckoo, because it's flagged on the eBird filter, that means you should have already dealt with it when you did your eBird submission. So I'm going to just click that one off. I know that I already added comments when I was entering it into eBird, so I don't need to add more for that one. Field sparrow is the double S. That's the species of interest. So two different atlas flags here based on breeding evidence. So blue and teal, here it is. So I'm going to add details. You'd write a description, and you can remember you can add coordinates for even common stuff, but it's especially important for rare stuff, rare breeders. So I'm going to switch to satellite view. It's a little easier. The track log is hard to see on this view. I'll switch back to the map so you can see it a little easier. But it's easier, I find, to use the satellite view for plotting stuff correctly. So it was at this creek. I click it, and I'm going to put in that there was two individuals there. Close. Okay, so I'm done blueing teal. And just quick scroll down to field sparrow. Add details. Good. Okay, I put some details in, and I'm going to add the coordinates for that one, too. It was in this field right here. Right there. Close. Okay, so I've addressed that. I'm going to do one more last check. Scroll through here, see that there's no more flags. There is a warning here, this yellow icon beside the breeding evidence code I used for song sparrow. I'll click it, get the details. And so the yellow is an unusual code. They can be used, but you should limit their use to exceptional cases. And there should be some details. So for the NU code, which is use nest, says caution nest or egg shells not unique or unmistakable. Basically saying that's a tough ID. Are you sure? So I'm going to close and I'm going to just delete that code because I'm not so sure anymore now that I see that it is in fact a very tough ID. Okay, so I've done everything. And normally you wouldn't have any of these extra flags likely. And it would just be a matter of quick skimming through, make sure everything looked okay, and then clicking submit. This time it took a couple extra minutes because of the extra flags that we had tripped. Okay, once it's submitted, it's into the Atlas, and you should see this little icon now saying this checklist has been shared with eBird, and it's got a checklist ID, which should be the same one that you had before. If you click it, it will open up that checklist in eBird. So it opens it up in eBird, and all the changes that you made to your checklist in the Atlas should have already been brought through into your eBird checklist. You can see it's got those details I added for the blueing teal. And the other really handy thing to be aware of is it adds this little thing that says Nature Counts Breeding Bird Atlas to the checklist comments. So that's a handy way to know when you're just sort of scrolling through your eBird checklist, handy way to know whether you've already shared that out with the Atlas. So that's it. It's pretty straightforward. And hopefully you can make good use of this nice feature.